You're listening to Ireland's Aviation Podcast.
Welcome to episode 4 of our second season of Short Final from Squawk 7000. On this week's podcast, a great week for Irish aviation as a consortium agreed to take a majority stake in Weston Airport. Aer Lingus and Emerald Airlines agree on a 10-year franchise agreement, and Ryanair will restore the second-based aircraft at Shannon Airport. And we've a chance for you to win a flight in a Boeing 737 MAX full flight simulator.
This week, Aer Lingus announced that it's entered into a franchise agreement with Emerald Airlines, which will commence on the 1st of January 2023 for 10 years for the operation of the Aer Lingus regional flights. Although the contract is not due to commence for 18 months, Aer Lingus has said it continues to work closely with Emerald Airlines to evaluate options concerning an earlier contract start date in light of Stobart Air recently ceasing operations. The new franchise agreement between the two airlines will support Aer Lingus's Dublin hub strategy by connecting UK provincial airports to North America via Dublin. Under the agreement, Emerald Airlines will operate ATR turboprop aircraft on the regional routes with associated Aer Lingus branding and livery. Over 400 staff will be required between now and the commencement of services. Following the unexpected closure of Stobart Air in June, Aer Lingus launched a replacement schedule for Aer Lingus regional customers, operating 6 routes until at least the end of March 2022. BA Cityflyer is also operating 4 additional routes for the rest of the summer 2021 period.
The owner of Weston Airport, Brian Keneally, has announced that he has successfully negotiated with an investment group to take a majority stake in Weston Airport. The completion of the transaction is conditional on due diligence, binding documentation and regulatory consents. General and business aviation coupled with flight training will continue to be the primary focus of the investors and the current owner. Derek Walsh, a Limerick-based financier, leads investors including John Brennan, Catherine Green, John Collison and Gerald Dundon. The group intends to upgrade facilities and develop Weston as a general aviation centre. Bar, restaurant and conference facilities will be enhanced and improvements will also be made to the terminal, aircraft storage and hangar areas. All current staff will be retained and it's envisaged that additional employment could be created for the local area as new services are introduced. The new investors are aviation enthusiasts focused on turning Weston into a state-of-the-art facility, the group said. Weston Airport was established in 1931 by Darby Kennedy, a founding father of aviation in Ireland. It's primarily used for flight training and occasional business jet traffic. The airport incorporates 9,000 square metres of operational buildings, an air traffic control tower, 3 large hangars and around 20 aircraft are based there.
This week on the Flying in Ireland website, we're asking how current are your flying skills. In the past 3 months, there have been 7 incidents and accidents involving general aviation aircraft. 6 of these involved the landing phase, which were either categorised as runway excursion or abnormal runway contact. The article has some very useful links for general aviation pilots, some of which may be particularly relevant for pilots who have flown less than they normally would have over the last 18 months.
Ryanair has announced 8 new routes from Shannon and will base a second aircraft at the airport as part of its Shannon tourism recovery schedule. This expansion will result in Ryanair operating 16 routes from Shannon this summer and 18 routes for the winter. The new routes include Corfu, Las Palmas, Birmingham, Budapest, Edinburgh, Fuerteventura, London Luton and Turin. The airline will operate 85 departing flights across the 34 routes and the second-based aircraft will support these expanded schedules. Ryanair carried 9.3 million passengers during July with an 80% load factor. This is a considerable increase from the 5.3 million carried during June. Traffic is yet to make a significant recovery in Ireland and the UK. The majority of these passengers were carried on continental routes where travel restrictions were eased on the 1st of July.
Dublin-based Milestone Aviation Group have announced that it is providing 2 Airbus H145 helicopters to Cork Expeditions, a leader in polar adventures. The aircraft will be stationed on the dual helidecks of the Cork Expedition's brand new ultramarine expedition ship. They'll be used to provide passengers with unique adventure opportunities in the polar regions. Described as the most immersive polar helicopter program, the aircraft will be used for activities such as heli-hiking, heli-supported kayaking and trekking. Milestone, which is a GECAS company, now owns over 300 rotary wing aircraft.
Well, last week's episode reported that Swedish airline Amapola Flying has begun operating the Dublin to Donegal PSO route. Flying in Ireland contributor Paul Colby recently travelled on the service and has written a short article with photographs from the trip that you can read on the website. We'll be back in a moment with an opportunity for you to win a flight in a Boeing 737 MAX full flight simulator in Dublin. Stay with us.
Do you fancy a flight in a Boeing 737 MAX full flight simulator in Dublin? If so, you can enter our competition to win an hour flying in the sim by answering the following question. How many simulators are located at Airline Flight Academy in Dublin? If you're not sure, you'll find the answer in the feature article on the Airline Flight Academy published this week on the Flying in Ireland website. Email your answer to win@flyinginireland.com before next Friday to be in with a chance of winning.
This week's long final features a chat with pilot and Burr Airshow commentator Colm Wright. More on that in a moment. Well, I was in Burr this week on Friday to talk with some of the people behind the very successful Irish Aviation Golf Challenge, which to date has raised over €200,000 for St Vincent de Paul. At the very busy registration tent, I caught up with the organiser, Captain Shea Party.
Four!
Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle.
Shea Party, we're here in Burr once again. And 2021, did you even think this event would happen?
We've been very lucky over the years, Michael, and amazing turnout this year. 160 players down from all over the country, including a team, came in from Brussels. So great support, great cause, and absolutely fabulous turnout.
And needless to say, with the COVID situation, you've had to do it slightly differently. Everybody's playing separately, eating separately. But it's working.
Yeah, it is socially distanced, as you said, and it's different. But people come because it's the one occasion in the year they might meet their colleagues or friends that they haven't seen year on year. So a number of them coming since we started 22 years ago now. And fantastic. Last year we were up over 200,000, and this year we're going to make, we believe, in excess of 250 total. So it's an amazing year.
The generosity is amazing.
It is, yeah, and from the aviation community, and if you think of the turmoil that people have gone through, it is amazing, absolutely, yeah, and great support. The book has been a major part. On schedule, things also came our way, so we're very pleased.
No Bray this year.
No Bray, no, but hopefully next year we'll start back in September, going to talk to the council initially in Wicklow and see can we can. Obviously the electric picnic news has upset plans that we would have liked to have pushed on with, but we'll see, hopefully next year.
Well, best of luck with the golf today, and that the rain stays away, and we'll have the winner of the competition announced in our news at the end of this bulletin.
Excellent. Well, thank you as always for your support.
Hello, my name is Marion Carter. I volunteer with the Vincent de Paul in Burr for the past 14 years.
Marion, the connection between the aviation golf event and St Vincent de Paul, tell us more about that.
Well, we've been with Shea Party for the past 22 years. This is 22nd year. It's absolutely vital that this is done every year. He's a superman, super to the Vincent de Paul in Burr. All the money raised goes towards education. We also in Vincent de Paul deal with people with, you know, vouchers and financial help, various things, but this is solely for education. Basically, it's helping people start off, get accommodation, put down a deposit. People from housing estates that would have never gone to college, people whose families have never gone to college, these are the first people in their family line that are actually going there.
And can you give us an idea of the amounts that have been raised over the years?
Oh, now. Gosh, over 22 years, I'd say we're well over 200,000 has been raised. Normally it's about 16,000 to 18,000 every year. It seems to climb every year.
And the idea that the money is ring-fenced for education, what's the idea behind that?
It was Shea's idea that it was for education, and we're quite happy to row in with that. Like, we wouldn't have enough money in the conference to set aside for education because there's such a demand on us, and this year in particular, huge demand because of COVID. At the minute, we're helping people who would normally give us a contribution at Christmas through our church gate collection or otherwise a donation. These people then were on pub payment of 350. They were normally taking home maybe €600 or €700 a week, and then their outgoings are still the same. So these were people coming to us for help in case they got into financial trouble themselves. Basically, they were looking for food vouchers, maybe fuel, basic things to keep them going.
And so at the event today, of course, you're wishing all the best to the golfers.
Absolutely. Wishing them all the best. Hope the weather stays kind to them. It looks quite nice at the minute. I was dreading the forecast last night, but actually it looks quite nice today. So hopefully, and as you can see, the course is in pristine condition as usual. And thanks to the golf club as well for hosting this every year.
Jim O'Farrell. I'm an artist from Limerick. Been painting, I suppose, since I was about 8 or 9 years of age. Always loved art. Then I became a teacher in hospital, County Limerick, in John the Baptist Community School. I took early retirement in 2010, and I wanted to paint full time, and that's what I do now. I have my studio in County Limerick, in Clarina, County Limerick.
Jim, tell me your connection with the event today.
Well, the Irish Aviation Golf Challenge group commissioned me to do a painting of Burr Golf Club. They wanted to present that to the club for the kindness that they have shown them over the years. So I was delighted. And mind you, it was a challenge because going around to the undulated areas of the club, trying to get the right angle, trying to get an angle that would be, I suppose, interesting for the public. That was my challenge. And I made several visits here, morning time and evening. But I found the evening time was the time to be there because I had a lovely soft light coming in from the right.
I was going to compliment you on the sky in the picture particularly. I mean, anybody in aviation and pilots love clouds that are well captured.
Yeah.
Was there any license in that?
I'll tell you, I needed a light that wouldn't distract from the body of the painting. And I think sometimes artists can make the mistake of making skies too beautiful or trying to make them too beautiful. And I think they can be a distraction. The sky should be background. But a sense of warmth as well. And the light that I was trying to portray was that warmth in a very, very faint cloud effect.
But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
And the winning team this year, in first place with a stellar score of 46.4, the Lusma Aviators, Barry Kelly, Stephen Lonergan, Barry Harding and Stephen Wynne. 152 played in Burr on Friday with €15,000 raised, and the total to date now stands at an incredible €252,000. In second place, representing CAE Park, Simon Kennedy, Alan Nugent, Peter O'Connor and Sam Callaghan with a score of 48.8. And taking third with a score of 49.2, the legendary Robbie Merrigan, Rita Barry, Stephen Campbell and Father Liam Merrigan.
And finally this week, Air Trade Aviation, the aviation technical asset services and trading company with a specialist aircraft disassembly facility at Knock, has been awarded the Aircraft Fleet Recycling Association accreditation. AirTrade provides disassembly services for all Airbus, Boeing, Embraer, Bombardier and ATR types. AirTrade has disassembled regional and commercial aircraft of all sizes from ATR 72 to A380 aircraft. AirTrade's operations and expansion in the west of Ireland have created employment in the region. It expects its employee numbers to increase significantly soon as the organisation continues its rapid growth. The company has recently secured planning permission to construct a huge hangar at the facility. This new hangar will be large enough to facilitate the A380-sized aircraft. They have also made an application for Part 145 approvals with the Irish Aviation Authority to increase the scope of AirTrade's service offerings to its clients. AirTrade will expand its disassembly capability as it commences CFM56 series engines teardowns in the Dublin facility in Q3 2021.
Thanks, Mark, and you'll find these stories and more on flyinginireland.com. And a reminder that you can listen to our long final editions. This week, I talk with pilot and Burr Airshow commentator Colm Wright. You'll find it wherever you get your podcasts on our site, squawk7000.ie. Thanks for listening.
To get the news first, subscribe now to Squawk 7000 on your favorite podcast platform.